Did you know that some cardiologists are now saying there is a certain blood marker that is more accurate in predicting heart attack risk than cholesterol? What's more, most doctors aren't focusing on it. We'll explain what this marker is in just a minute, as well as five tips to optimize the levels of it in order to help avoid cardiovascular disease. But first, make sure to like this video and subscribe to Heart Disease Code. We've got amazing new content each week. Also, stick around, because later in this video, we'll show you how to receive two free gifts on us. So what is this blood marker that some experts claim is a more accurate measure of heart attack risk? It is triglycerides. Interestingly, a standard lipid panel blood test will tell you four things: total cholesterol, HDL or good cholesterol, LDL or bad cholesterol, and triglycerides. Out of these four, the focus is normally on cholesterol, with the triglycerides rarely being discussed. However, they're very significant. For example, high triglyceride levels are an indicator of metabolic health, insulin resistance, and likelihood of inflammation. And therefore, the chances of inflammation-driven diseases such as heart disease developing. A 2007 meta-analysis of over 200,000 patients concluded triglycerides are an independent risk factor for coronary artery disease. So what are triglycerides and how do they affect the blood vessels? Triglycerides are a form of fat. When you eat extra calories that your body doesn't need to use immediately, it converts them to triglycerides. This is especially true when carbohydrates are consumed, as your liver increases the production of triglycerides. When you have excess triglycerides, they're stored in fat cells for later use. Too many or constantly high levels of triglycerides can be hugely problematic. This is because high levels indicate that insulin resistance is occurring, meaning your pancreas will be working harder to produce insulin. In this scenario, fat around the organs will begin to form, which is highly inflammatory. Having increased inflammation increases risk of many conditions such as cancers, dementia, diabetes, and heart disease. Further cause for concern is how high triglycerides affect LDL or bad cholesterol. According to cardiologist Dr. William Davis, high triglyceride levels cause an excess of small LDL particles. LDL cholesterol is like a bus that carries cholesterol, fat-soluble vitamins, and other important substances through the blood. But some research is now showing that the amount of LDL cholesterol in the blood isn't necessarily as problematic as the condition and size of the LDL particles. After all, only 50% of heart attack victims have raised LDL cholesterol. This statistic has had researchers scratching their heads. But in recent years, scientists have found that the LDL particle size and condition could be more indicative of heart attack risk than the amount of LDL cholesterol in the blood. Testing has shown that small and dense LDL cholesterol is more problematic for blood vessels than large and buoyant LDL. A number of studies have shown this theory to be true. For example, a 2007 trial found that LDL particle numbers were twice as predictive for cardiac events as the total amount of LDL, the traditional testing method. Plus, a 2001 study looked at the number of LDL particles and the risk of heart attacks. The researchers found that those with the highest number of LDL particles had four times the risk of a heart attack, in contrast to those with the lowest number. Another thing to note about triglycerides is their ratio to HDL cholesterol, otherwise known as good cholesterol. If triglycerides go up and HDL goes down, the risk for heart disease is greatly increased. A Danish study on nearly 3,000 men confirmed this. They found those who had a lower ratio of triglycerides to HDL had significantly less risk of heart disease, even if they had other risk factors such as hypertension, smoking, or sedentary lifestyles. A further Harvard study reported that those who had the highest triglycerides to HDL ratios had a 16 times the risk of developing heart disease in comparison to those with the lowest ratios. To calculate the ratio, take the triglyceride number and divide it by the HDL number. For example, if you have triglycerides of 150 milligrams per deciliter and HDL of 50 milligrams per deciliter, you divide 150 by 50 and you get a ratio of 3. A more optimal ratio would be 2. Therefore, it's essential to uncover how to lower triglycerides. We'll learn about that in just a moment. And I'll reveal how a type of starch found in certain foods could be wreaking havoc on your cardiovascular health. But first, if you want to learn more about reducing your risk of a heart attack, then why not download our free ebook, The Surprising Truth About Fat and Cholesterol? And if you'd really like to understand the full picture for fighting and preventing heart disease, check out episode 1 of The Untold Story of Heart Disease. Both gifts are free and waiting for you now. Just click the link in the description below. Our number 5 way to reduce triglycerides is intermittent fasting. Does the idea of fasting make you want to run for the hills? Fasting can sure seem like a daunting task, but in recent years, intermittent fasting has gained in popularity, as people find it easy to do and get great results. So how does it work? At first, you can start with simply shortening your eating window. For example, you might just eat dinner an hour earlier and breakfast an hour later. Unlike diets where you follow strict rules of what you can and can't eat, with this you eat the same foods but in a shorter time frame. For example, if you finish dinner at 6 p.m. and start breakfast at 8 a.m, you have a 14-hour fast. For most, this is easily achievable. Then you might do a couple of days a week where you eat breakfast at 10 a.m. This would give you a 16-hour fasting window. Adjusting your lifestyle to eat this way can be beneficial for weight loss, increased energy, and triglyceride levels. One British study looked at participants who followed the 5-2 intermittent fasting schedule. This is when people eat normally for 5 days a week, and then 2 days a week limit their calories to under 500. They found participants who used this method of intermittent fasting reduced their post-meal triglycerides by 40%. Another study found that those who did alternate day fasting saw significant lower levels of triglycerides. Other benefits of intermittent fasting include decreased insulin levels, which facilitates fat loss, increased levels of human growth hormone, HGH. Higher levels of this hormone also facilitates fat burning along with muscle gain. Cellular repair increases, allowing the body to get rid of waste that it doesn't need. Helps fight inflammation, a key driver of heart disease. If you're keen to try intermittent fasting, then work your way up slowly. However, if attempting longer fasts, be sure to consult with your physician, especially if you're a diabetic. A number 4 way of reducing triglycerides naturally is to balance gut bacteria. We already discussed the role gut health can play in the production of small LDL cholesterol, so it should come as no surprise that it can also play a role with triglycerides. Ensuring we feed the good bacteria in the gut with the right type of fiber enables them to convert into butyrate. This is a fatty acid that produces positive metabolic effects, such as reducing triglycerides, insulin resistance, and blood sugar. All of these factors help decrease risk of cardiovascular disease. Cultivating a healthy gut can be done by eating a diverse range of plant foods, eating probiotic foods such as sauerkraut, yogurt, kefir, and fermented vegetables, consuming prebiotics, which are fibers that feed good bacteria. Prebiotics can be found in foods such as cold potatoes, garlic, and onion. Our next tip to lower triglycerides flies in the face of traditional nutritional advice. Number 3 is avoid grains. You might be wondering why we should avoid grains. Isn't brown rice and sourdough bread good for me? This might be true if it wasn't for something called amylopectin A. This is a type of carbohydrate found in starches such as potatoes, bread, and rice. A 2004 study found that eating a diet high in amylopectin A led to increases in cholesterol and triglyceride levels. This was in comparison to a diet high in amylose. Amylose is also a starch, but is much slower to be absorbed and doesn't send blood sugar levels as high. One of the most visible effects of a diet rich in amylopectin A is an expanding waistline. When blood sugar levels are spiked regularly, we see an increase in insulin, leading to weight gain around the belly. The hormone insulin plays a key role in fat storage and function of metabolism. Having insulin resistance can increase the uptake of triglycerides from the blood into fat cells, as well as block the breakdown of fat. Furthermore, eating foods that are high in amylopectin A has been shown to increase hunger, therefore leading to overeating, causing a knock-on effect of rising triglycerides along with belly bulge and insulin resistance. Number 2. Avoid sugar. This may not come as a surprise, as we just discussed how grains raise blood sugar levels, and it goes without saying that sugar will too. Furthermore, sugar is one of the most addictive substances known to man. Therefore, eating foods that are high in sugar can lead to overeating, resulting in a much higher level of triglycerides and the inflammation that goes along with it. If you're not ready to cut out all sugars, start off with the worst offenders, which are the sweet beverages such as soda and fruit juices. These provide no fiber, so the sugar hit is much harder on the body than eating sugar from foods containing fiber, which slow the release of sugar into the bloodstream. After cutting sugary drinks, next cut down on added sugars, commonly found in foods such as cookies, cakes, and candy. If you feel you need some sweetness, try a healthier alternative such as honey or maple syrup, but use them in moderation. These provide nutrients, whereas white processed table sugar is just calories. We're about to reveal our number one way to lower triglycerides, which is an easy way to help lower your risk of a heart attack, with many scientific studies to back it up. But first, if you want to learn more about reducing your risk of a heart attack, then why not download our free ebook, The Surprising Truth About Fat and Cholesterol? And if you'd really like to understand the full picture for fighting and preventing heart disease, check out episode 1 of The Untold Story of Heart Disease. Both gifts are free and waiting for you now. Just click the link in the description below. Our number one way to reduce triglycerides is to add in lots of healthy omega-3 fatty acids to your diet. These can be found in foods such as extra virgin olive oil, avocado, oily fish like sardines and salmon. Firstly, let's look at extra virgin olive oil. Numerous studies on it have found that it protects bad LDL cholesterol from oxidation, which, as we have learned, is normally caused by high triglycerides. These studies have also found extra virgin olive oil lowers inflammation, improves the lining of your blood vessels, and may help prevent excessive blood clotting. Next, let's look at how avocado measures up. A 2015 analysis of numerous studies found that avocado consumption was associated with significant reduction in total cholesterol, LDL levels, and triglyceride levels. How about the evidence for oily fish consumption? A study in the US found that men who ate fish more than once a week had a 15% lower risk of heart disease. Plus, a 2016 study on overweight women found that when they ate salmon twice a week, their triglyceride levels dropped and their LDL particle size improved. So why not try adding some delicious omega-3 rich foods to your diet? And let us know in the comments below which tip you find most helpful for reducing triglycerides. Now you know what to look for the next time you have a lipid blood panel. Make sure to stay tuned to Heart Disease Code to discover more wonderful nutrition and wellness insights. And once again, don't leave without grabbing both of your two free gifts. Just click that link below. Thanks for watching. Have a heart-healthy day.